We all know the development of information and the communication technology is developed so fast. And in my perspective, there is like data interactions on the road among people, vehicles, and the roads. So I developed a similar data process circle for like network monitoring, include modeling, monitoring, and controlling. This work has been accepted by transportation science in 2017. So the case study is built on this the methodology proposed in this paper. So the main objective for this paper is to monitor a system network attributes using real-time data. This figure is like a testbed or platform from Gaudemap, and I select the same city I used in my case study is Wuhan, China. In their like website, we can like check the travel time change to the link level. For example, you can see this table. The table below, we do monitor the real time speed, travel time delay on like a road segment, and we also can get like a sense of the congestion level in congestion delay index along the time. But the problem is, we can monitor the travel time and we can know the travel time on the road, but we cannot explain people's choice due to the information. So that is kind of motivating me to propose the network learning methodology to explain why people change their road choice. So I use like a simple numerical ND network to explain why the state change. In this case, using the current machine learning or statistics modeling, you can calculate the total system travel time. For example, in this state, we can calculate the total system travel time is 68,400. But we know when the state change, when there's like capacity constraint on the link 7, and the total system travel time can increase to 70,000. And using the sensors data, we can monitor the volume, the flow change on the highlight links in star. But problem exists. Why does the state change occur? So the previous work answers the question like how can a transportation system learn through its agents? Can we use the real-time taxi data on network impact instance? And we also answer the question the relationship between agencies and the users. How to monitor the latent attributes of transportation system that can explain the behavior of heterogeneous users, which the latent attributes of transportation system can be dubbed as the congestion effect, the link capacity effect. So in a previous work, we formalized a class of models to infer system parameters from different agent learning. And the technology is, the methodology is built from like inverse optimization. So I would like to give a brief introduction about what is inverse optimization. For given parameter C0 and the linear programmed parameter and observed decision variables, the optimal X. And we want to determine an updated cost such as the optimal X while minimizing the its alpha norm from the pair. And we can also reformulate this to a linear program to introduce two non-negative variables E and I. And to using this simple and easy calculate linear programming, we can build a multi-agent framework. At first, I set this multi-agent inverse problem as a fixed point problem. So we first give an initial guess of a common pair, and then we have a set of inverse statistics class problems, one for each agent, because we have we want to get information from heterogeneous agents. And later we do parameter learning in the constraint to have inverse common curve. So by after have the very basic framework, we decide to consider the number of parameters in that framework. We want to think about the capacity multi-community flow problem. So we use we're using agent inverse optimization to evaluate the capacity effect. So here is the main methodology I propose. We use the decomposition, but the main problem, the main capacity problem, can be decomposed into a master problem to determine the optimal goal price and the unconstrained subproblem for each community. I will explain the step one by one in later slides. So for the master problem, capacity multi-community flow problem, in previous study by Gilder and Hamacher, they proposed an inverse optimization to find the capacity for single community problem that they found is NP-hard. So in this work, we are not find the value for the capacity. We want to find the effect in travel time of the capacity. So we decided to decompose this main problem into two parts. The first part is the restricted master problem, and from the partial authorization theorem, the capacity, the door price in the capacity problem is equivalent to the door price from n capacity shortest path problem is from of each community. So it can be formulated like this, and then after solving the shortest path double problem, we can they can help us reach the fixed common curve. And here's the one of the numerical experiments I did to explain if we update the belief of door price with observations obtained over time, do they converge? Can the methodology work? So I use the same in the network, and there are. I like design three scenarios. The first scenario is I draw 100 random samples under the 400-800 capacity on link 1 and the link 7. And in the second scenario, I draw 100 more samples by decreasing the link capacity on link 7 down to 500. And for the 100 more samples, we increase the capacity back. Imagine when one incident happened on one link, the capacity drops for a short time period, and when the incident resolved and the link status was recovered back to its original capacity. So here is the result. The top figure shows the path ID observed from each state. You can see for state B, when we observed the capacity was lower on the particular link, we observed different links here. I think it's link 13, yeah. And also we compute the door price under each state for link 1 and the link B. And then we can see the door price converge to 7 and 5 or 6, 8. And when we change the capacity, the door price for link 7 is increased from 5 to 6. So we know there are other learning methods exist, but we compare the computational efficiency, ours is much more efficient. update the decision is sent to the system, and we use our algorithm to learn the observation and later update the link capacity progress. So the data we got is something like this table. So we do have the status of the taxi, which means if it is zero, it means the taxi is not occupied. If it one means like passengers like in the car. We use all the occupied taxi data because we assume taxi with passengers will select the shortest path when they drop off their passenger. This shows the study network from Wuhan. The city is pretty big, so we decide to focus its urban area. In Benzhongmin, we have 2,833 links and 855 nodes in the study area. So before applying our algorithm, we are looking at the taxi pickups and the drop off to find the study OD pair. This figure is the heat map for pickups, and the other one is the heat map for drop offs. We use the 1 day data, it's May 6th, 2014. And by zooming in, we select the OD pairs. In this case study, we study two OD pairs. One is from Zhongjiachun to Pangxi'jia station, and another one is from this station to Wuchang rail station. So how do I conduct this case study? First, initiate with low price equals to zero for all links in the urban transportation network in Wuhan. And the second step, we choose the study period from 5 a.m. in morning, and we update the door price every 5 minutes until 9 a.m. So the study period is 4 hours in the morning. And we choose origin and destination pairs from the heat map of pickup and drop off. And then we run the path recovery algorithm to get the real-time traveler's choice for each of the OD pairs. And then in the last, we run our online learning to update the link door price based on the observations. This figure is just an example, shows how the route change along with time. So just select some time period to see how people make different choice on the route. So based on these observations, we calculate the link capacity door price for links. In this one is first of all one OD pair from Zhongjiachun to Wuchang rail station, and the highlighted link shows the observations, the link observed from 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. though the magnitude are not same, but we can see the trend and has similar pattern. And I calculated the correlation between real trial time and estimated trial time to 0.94, which means our methodology do like behaves has similar behavior like compared with the real trial time because we use the free flow speed to get the trial time used for estimation, so they may have it may cause some difference. Later on, when we do more calculation, the result will be much more close. So that's for next step. Here is the summary for today's presentation. Actually, I combine our previous work and also the current work together. The previous work shows the methodology I used for the case study. It demonstrated the use in capturing heterogeneity, and it showed that it can infer shared network state parameters in polynomial time. And I also showed that inference can be conducted in machine learning manner to monitor instances. So for a case study, I validated its practical application in real world. So for future work, I would like to design more online learning systems that incorporate time value of the observation and iteration rate of the process. That's all for today. Thank you.
We have time for a number of questions.
Accurate the model it is. So in the case study, I speed for the free flow network to calculate the free flow travel time when I estimate the value estimation in my model. So that caused the underestimate.
Can you show me your result, you know, for the estimated and the actual? Yeah, it looks like an underestimate, but I can see some pattern that, you know, it has a, you know, the similar, you know, the pattern with the estimated and the just the actual value. So do you think if you introduce some more variable to, you know, move this horizon to the little higher, so maybe it could be, you know, a better, you know, bring the better result. But do you have in mind about, you know, some?
Yeah, that could be more next step. When I got the result, I think similar pattern. For example, include more observation or include more variables to get invited to the language. But this graph just showed it has a very high strong correlation between my estimation and the real time. So later on, when I do more calculation,
I think it depends on, also depends on some sample rate. So your text data. So meaning that the traffic condition is a dependent variable on the location of the taxi.
Yeah.
So in sometimes when the taxi is located at some the free flow speed area and then this is congested, it just estimated the traffic condition as a free flow. But once it got stuck in the the congested area, maybe this the data will be overestimated.
Yeah,
I just think that's one of them.
One more question.
So you are basically assuming that sample taxi trajectory is representative to the all the commodities, right?
Yeah.
But for sample for the taxi driver, they are basically familiar with those routes. Probably they are travel faster than any other.
That's kind of like they are like endogenous variable we cannot control that well. So it could be right. Like some taxi drivers are experienced and they familiar with the road they are traveling.
Join me in thanking Dr. Susan Xu.